guys, this is Kelsey with Kelsey Freeman Photography. I'm going to show you guys how I'm going to edit this picture using Lightroom and Photoshop. I'm going to start off in Lightroom and then we'll go into Photoshop for the finishing touches. Little pre-note here, if you hear a video going and my baby, it is what it is. Work when you can. So she's up from her nap a little early. So anyway, as you can see, the picture is a little on the dark side. I love to shoot underexposed a little bit. I just find that I can have the most detail and some really great rich colors when I do shoot underexposed and when I shoot in RAW. That's really important, shooting in RAW for me at least. So I'm going to start here in Lightroom, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually use the preset August. So I'm going to click it and you see it's going to do the work for me. It adds a really nice warm tone to your pictures, but it's a little warm for my taste for this picture, and so what I'm going to do is I'm going to tweak a few things to really make this picture exactly how I want it before I open it into Photoshop. One thing to point out, presets are great because they help you with your workflow, they help speed up your editing and keep your pictures looking really consistent. And a lot of times they are one click and done, but for me, I always like to tweak them a little bit just to get them exactly how I want them, because every picture is different. Even in the same session, I will tweak things here and there because lighting is different, your angles and where the sun is, and the temperature of the warmth and everything where you are at a location. It can all change even at one session. So I always like to tweak things. That's one thing I hear a lot, is people kind of expecting everything to be one click and done. And you know, it can be, but to keep your style consistent, it's nice to know how to kind of tweak things here and there. So that's what we're going to do. So anyway, the first thing I want to do is bring in my exposure just a little bit, because it is a good bit on the dark side. So I'm going to bring this up. So maybe about there. That's pretty good. Now, I also want to bring the temperature down a bit. It is nice and warm, but I'm also going to do some things in Photoshop to give me a really nice different kind of warmth, more of like a brown tone. So I'm going to cool this down just a little bit. So I'm going to come up here to my temperature, and I'm going to bring this down maybe a little bit more, just until it looks still, you know, not too crazy cool, but definitely cooler than what it was. And in my tint, I'm just going to bring it up just a little bit to make it a little bit more on the magenta side. So maybe about there. Now, next thing I do is kind of do any highlight, shadows, saturation, those sort of tweaks. So I do want to bring up the shadows a little bit off the base. It's kind of dark, especially here in the center. So where my shadows are, I'm going to bring these up a little bit, just until I'm happy with kind of how it's looking. So maybe about there or so looks all right. And everything else, I like the lighting. I'm not going to tweak anything else. The only other thing I want to do up here is tweak the saturation. I want to add a little bit more color, so that looks pretty good. Now, when you go down a little bit, you'll find your detail section, and you know, it sharpens your pictures a good bit. I really like a nice, crisp, sharp-looking picture, so I always add sharpening, but I do also want to add some luminance under the noise reduction, and what this is going to do is just add a really creamy sort of look to it. So I'm going to scroll this up a little bit, and I really just pay attention to skin tones, nothing else, and I think that looks pretty good. I'm not, you know, going too crazy where everything just looks like waxy and totally fake. I normally stay in the 20 to 30 range, so somewhere around there. And then I'm going to come on down to effects, and this preset will put a grain on your picture. I love it most of the time, but for this picture I don't want any, so I'm just going to hit 0 and enter and get rid of that grain for this picture. Lastly, what I want to do is brighten up their faces, their bodies a little bit before I take it into Photoshop. While I'm here and I'm working on the raw image, I might as well take advantage of that, and so I'm going to brighten up here where I can have really nice control. So I'm going to click on the brush, the adjustment brush right here, and I'm just going to make sure my brush is, I'm going to make it small and just kind of brighten up these girls' faces, and then I'll brighten up their whole bodies. So my exposure I've got on plus 0.40, and I'm just going to brush over her face and over her face, and then I'm going to press enter. I'm good with that one, so I'm going to make my brush even bigger this time and kind of get their bodies. The exposure I'm going to bring down just a little bit, and now I'm going to kind of brush over all of it. Looks awesome. Okay, so that looks pretty good to me. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to export this, and we'll open it up into Photoshop. Alrighty, so now we are in Photoshop, and the first thing I like to do before I really do anything else is do any basic tweaks that might need to be fixed. I like to retouch the skin. So I'm going to go ahead and zoom on in here, and we're going to work on some spots on her arms and legs, and we'll kind of fix their skin up. So the first thing I want to do is I like to duplicate my background layer, and I'm a very much hands-on kind of keyboard person. I like to pretty much keep my left hand on my keyboard, my right hand on my mouse while I'm editing. It just helps me have a quicker workflow. So what I'm going to do is press Control J. You can press Command J if you're on a Mac, or you can just right-click your background layer and press Duplicate. So anyway, I have got my extra layer, and this way, if I happen to do something I don't like and I want to undo it, it's easier just to have a background layer in case anything happens and I kind of prefer something that was on the original. So I want to get rid of like this spot here, this stuff on her arm. So the easiest way I can think of to start off is the spot healing brush. And so all I'm going to do is just make sure my brush is big enough to kind of hover over these spots, and I'm going to click once and it'll disappear. So I'm going to make my brush a little bigger. And if you're wondering how I'm making my brush bigger without going to the brush panel right here, I'm using my bracket keys on my keyboard, so the left bracket will make your brush smaller, the right bracket makes your brush bigger. So I'm just going to kind of hover over this and click it once, and that spot is pretty much gone. And I'm going to come over here to this section on her arm and kind of click right there as well and get rid of that, and then this one on her arm, kind of just go over any spots like that. And so yeah, I'm not going to get this spot on mom's hand because I believe that's a freckle. Anything that's always there on them, I don't want to change just because that's a part of who they are. And the other spots were just like bruises and things like that that I was getting rid of. And this one's like a little like white spot, but I believe that's like a freckle, so I'm going to keep that there. So let me go ahead and flatten now that I've gotten rid of those spots, and now we'll work on the skin. So the first thing I want to do is kind of smooth the skin. So I'm in the Wander Collection Actions right now, and when you come on down, you'll see the facial retouching section. It's got a whole bunch of stuff. I'm going to click on Smooth Skin and press Play, and then a little box will pop up, and it just lets you know what you will want to use, what kind of brush and that sort of thing. So make sure you're clicked on your black layer mask, but when you run the action, it's already going to be clicked there. So just make sure whenever you're brushing that it is selected on that layer mask. So I'm going to click my paintbrush, and what you want to do is use a white paintbrush on the black layer mask, the opposite color. And I'm going to adjust my opacity to probably about 40 or so. Also, if I tell you I'm adjusting a brush opacity or something and you don't see me come up here and scroll it, it's because I'm using my keyboard again. So for like 40%, if I press 4 on my keyboard, see, it changed my opacity to 40. Or if I press 3, it changes it to 30, and so on. So I'm going to start off and just kind of brush on mom's skin and just kind of smooth everything out. And I like to work around things so I'm not gonna blur out her freckle. And then I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller and come up here and brush on over her face. And I'm gonna pick my mouse up and then brush again on top of a spot that I thought needed an extra little bit of smoothing. And that way I have 40% on her twice, 40% opacity of the brush on that spot twice. So I'm just going to keep on going around, and I will resize my brush as needed. Make sure you don't go over any spots that have like dimples or lines in her face like this. Like, you don't want to get rid of that. Now, if it's like a forehead wrinkle or something, go for it. But something like that where it's like it adds to the smile, definitely don't touch it. So I'm going to kind of come over here and get her arm and get all of this. And then now I'm going to make my brush 60% to go over her skin. What I find that I personally like is to go a little overboard, not overboard, but a little more blur on little kids and then a little less on parents, because typically, naturally, on little kids' skin, it already looks a lot smoother and they don't have as much detail as adults. And so I will use a little extra blur on them to kind of get like that, I don't know, just a gorgeous sleek look on their skin. But for parents, I do want to keep a little bit of detail if I can. So I'm going to go around her legs like so. And then we will work on faces, because I believe we've got all the girls' arms now. So what I'm going to do is make my brush a bit smaller. I'm going to use 50% opacity on my brush on her face. Again, make sure not to get too close to the eyes or anything, because you don't want to lose all of that detail. If you go too crazy, you will start to look really they will look really Photoshopped. You see, I skipped over that little line where her smile is. You just don't want to tweak things that make them who they are and, you know, take away from her smile, because you don't notice it, but little things like that, dimples and such, when people smile or just anything like that, it kind of removes how they are, you know, how they look when they're naturally smiling. So try to avoid that. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead and flatten. There is a flatten for me action here. You can just press play and it'll flatten it. I just have a habit of pressing Control Shift E, and that flattens for me with my my left hand. So next thing I want to do is do some eye detail and press play. I use this on like every face that I ever edit, and I will do 100% opacity with this, and I just like to brush it over the eyes, the eyelashes. Honestly, I do it on the mouth and eyebrows too if I think it will add to it. It just adds so much amazing detail, and it just brings your eyes to the parts where you're supposed to be looking when you look at a picture, at somebody's eyes. And so I'm just going to press Control Shift E to flatten. And let's see here. So as far as skin retouching, that looks pretty good. So let's go ahead and run some actions to kind of enhance the overall look of the picture. So I'm going to zoom out here just so I can have a really good overall look. I'm going to scroll on down here, and I'm going to start off in the, there we go, the Arden collection. This action set is really for nice brown tones, but there's a bunch of different options to get any sort of kind of brown edit you're going for. And I like to stack actions. I like to use a lot at low opacity, and helps gives me different tones. So I'm going to start with Robin, and I'm going to press play. And I love Robin. It's a gorgeous kind of muted brown with great contrast. But I'm going to lower this opacity down to 20%. Also, if you want to adjust your opacity of your layers, as long as your brush isn't selected, then you can press your number, your numbers on your keyboard as well. So if I say, let's say I want to do 50% opacity, I just press a 5 on my keyboard and it's changed. But if your brush is selected and you try to do the number thing to adjust your layer, it won't work, because whenever you have your brush selected and you do the numbers on your keyboard, it will think you're talking about the opacity of your brush. So I have my selection tool selected, and now I can just use my numbers on my keyboard to adjust. So anyway, I've got 20% with Robin. I'm also going to do Raven. This one is a little bit different. It's got a little bit more of a golden tone to the browns. I'm also going to do 20% on this one, and then I'm going to scroll on up to the Wander collection, and I'm going to go to the tone add-on section there, and I'm going to run Kodiak and press play and also do 20%. So I feel like this gives me a really nice golden kind of brown look to my picture. I really love this. So I'm going to show you guys so far just the coloring that I got, the nice depth and brown tones that I got just from using those three actions so far at low opacity. You don't want to have high opacity on all of these layers, because you see if I have like 60% opacity on all of them, it does not look good. So you want to use relatively low opacity when you're using many actions, just to keep it from just kind of going crazy and overboard. And I feel like their skin looks a little bit green, so I'm going to scroll down back to the facial retouching of the Wander set, and I'm going to click on less green skin and press play. And again, a little dialog box will pop up and let you know what kind of brush to use. So just make sure you're using a white brush at a pretty low opacity. I'm going to use 30% and brush it over her skin, their hair as well. And I'm just going to keep resizing my brush as needed. And make sure you don't forget feet and legs, that sort of thing. And then let me get these fellas in the back. Actually, Dad's arm on the edge doesn't look too bad, so I'm going to skip that. All right. That looks much better to me, kind of getting rid of some of that green skin. Awesome. So I also want to see how it looks to do a little bit of overall brighten, and just to brighten up the center just a little bit more. So I'm going to use 30% just to see kind of how it looks and how it brightens them up. So let me see the before and the after. I like that. It adds a little bit of brightness. All right, so what I'm going to do now that I have colors that I really love is I'm going to add some vignettes and help draw your eye to the center. So I'm going to go to, I'm in the Wander collection. I'm going to scroll to the vignette section, and I'm going to run, let's see here, probably dark green vignette and continue. I'm going to grab a big brush, and the opacity I'm going to keep at, I'm going to do about 50. And I'm just going to brush around the edges like this because I just want to add some green contrast around the very outside. Now, I feel like I got a little bit of green kind of over them, and I don't want that. So I'm going to remove it. It's really easy. All you want to do is change from a white brush to a black brush. And so you can press X on your keyboard to do that, or you can press the little arrow here to toggle the colors. But just press X on your keyboard works as well. And then I'm going to bring my brush opacity to 100%, so I'm completely removing any of that green. And I'm brushing it off where I think it may have gotten on them. So I'm going to zoom on out here. And I'm going to grab, let's see here. You know what? I kind of want to crop this a little bit as well. They're a little too far on the left side. So before I go any further, I'm going to grab my crop tool and just crop it a little bit so they're more centered. Maybe a little less. That's probably good right about there. Okay, much better. And now I want to add some nice brown tones to the outside. So I'm going to click soft brown vignette and press play. And I'm going to grab my paintbrush, make sure it's really big. And you want to make sure you have a white paintbrush. I'm going to do 50% opacity. And I'm just going to brush from the outside like so. Perfect. Okay, I'm also going to come back in here and brush off any of this brown that got on them. So I put my brush back on black to erase it. 100% opacity on my brush, and I'm just going to go through and brush it off them. All right, so let me zoom out here and let me show you guys so far the before and after. Before and after. I love the moodiness. Okay, I think this picture really needs a sun, so I'm going to scroll on down here to the Arden Collection light add-ons. For this session, I've been using really vibrant suns. I think I want to use Vivid Sun on this one, so I'm going to press play. It's going to make the sun for you. They're really nice and soft and creamy. And I'm just going to drag it up and kind of put it around here. That's where the sun was coming from, kind of in the center. But I want to make the sun a little bit bigger, so I'm going to press Control T on my keyboard. And what this is going to do is transform my sun. Now, I could drag from the sides and make it a really long sun, and then I would end up with like an oval. Let me undo that. You can really transform it however. But if you want to make sure you keep it a perfect round circle, then hold Shift on your keyboard while you drag from the bottom corner or whatever corner. And if you're holding Shift, it's going to keep the ratio the same. So you'll have a perfectly round sun when you resize it. So I'm going to drag this up. Actually, I made it a little too big when I was talking. I'm going to pay attention to what I'm doing now. So I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. And actually, I do want to make it a little wider than it is tall. And so I'm going to put it maybe, I'm going to resize this a little bit till I'm happy with it. So maybe about there or so. I'm going to bring it up so it's not like overpowering the picture. And I love that. So you see what that did? Is it just added a really nice bit of warmth there. Let me try to rotate this a little bit and just see, with it being a little oblong, if it looks better kind of like this when I rotate it. I just kind of play around a bunch when I am editing just to kind of figure out exactly what I'm going for and what looks best. Also, don't be afraid to move your layers around. Because these actions down here have a good bit of contrast, sometimes I love to take my sun and put it below other layers, and it adds that contrast and the coloring from those layers on top of my sun. And so you see now it's not so in your face, and it's got a nice bit of contrast. And I really kind of like how that looks, so I'm probably going to keep that there. And then one more thing I want to do, this is not an action, this is just something that I love to do just to really help draw your eye to the center, is darkening the outsides of your picture by using curves or levels. So what I do is I go to my background layer and I press Control J on my keyboard to duplicate the layer. And now what I want to do is grab my my lasso tool, and I'm going to kind of draw a little circle around the outside like this, and then I'm just going to kind of go around, and now I've got all that on the outside and the bottom selected. Now, I want a really, really, really soft edge to this selection because I don't want there to be any hard lines from where I'm darkening the outside, so I want to have a really soft selection. So I'm going to press Shift and then F6, and this is going to bring up a feather selection. I normally like to do 200 to 300. It just gives me a really nice soft feather, but I'm going to stick with 300. And now I'm going to press Control M on my keyboard, and this brings up my curves. And what it's going to do is add this curves only to where I have the selection. It's not going to add a curves layer to my picture. It's only just going to apply this straight to that layer where the selection is. So you can see where my selection is. I can darken, I can brighten inside that selection. So I'm going to go back to where it was and just kind of bring it down a little bit like so. And I might even bring this bottom corner up a little bit to add a matte. You see, you can add a really nice matte by bringing this up where the shadows is. So maybe just a little bit. And then I'm going to click on preview and just kind of see what it did. It gave me a really nice looking depth. And I'm going to press OK. And then Control D to deselect. I also sometimes will select the inside as well and kind of work on where the people are. So I'm going to press Shift F6 again to bring up my feather selection, enter for OK, and then Control M to bring up the curves. And I'm going to bring this up maybe a little bit and maybe kind of make sure I keep my shadows down to keep that contrast. And you see it brightened it up a little bit. So I'm going to press OK and then Control D to deselect. So you see here, if I get hide this background layer where I added the darkness and the brightness, if I hide it, you can see it's just a little more blah, but when you run it, your eyes really pay attention to the middle because that's, it's just your eyes are drawn there because it's much brighter. I am going to do one more brush. Let me go to the vignette section of the Wander collection, and I'm probably going to do dark brown vignette and press play and grab my paintbrush. Let me do like 50% opacity here, make sure I have a white brush. And just kind of brush again, just on the very, very, very edges here, just to add a soft brown depth to it. And maybe I'll up this opacity of this layer, just to see kind of what all it looks like if I bring that up. So maybe about there or so. And a lot of times once I feel like I'm done editing, I'll go through and check out my layers and see if I want to up the opacity, bring it down a little bit, just to make sure I really like how it's looking. So maybe with Robin, let me bring it up and see how I like, or just any of these layers, just to kind of see what it does. Or shoot, I mean, I could even add on more. So I feel like it could look good to add on Pembroke. You never know till you try. It adds on a nice warmth. So if I bring that down to 0 and just kind of go up until my eyes are happy, so maybe around 13, it added some nice warmth. I don't want my picture getting too dark here though, so I might lower. I'm gonna bring this down to where all the other ones are. I might lower one of these, so I might lower Raven down to 15% and Robin down to 15%. And yeah, I really like how that's looking. So anyway, that's how I edit pictures with Lightroom and Photoshop. So I hope you guys learned a good bit, and thanks for watching. Okay, bye.